What does it say that you're one of the only Democratic candidates that's running on the merit of the American dream and that doesn't degrade it?
I think, you know, it's interesting. I don't know about all the candidates, but I know that some of the candidates have been advocating a wealth tax. I don't, because I don't think wealth is the problem. We want aspiration. It's part of the American dream, frankly. We want people to reach. What we don't want is greed. That's the problem. It's the hoarding of all of the benefits, you know, because that is counter to this community point I was making earlier, that we have some obligation to each other and to generations to come to leave things better. And that's not going to happen if we don't invest in each other.
The left wing of the Democratic Party tends to see candidates and issues through the lens of race and class. Mm. And you are a pioneering figure on the left in terms of when it comes to this question of race. Mm. You're on the wrong side of the divide when it comes to the question of class for the left wing of the Democratic Party.
For some.
Right. So how do you explain? I mean, you could be sort of a capitalism explainer, right? to the progressive base of the party. How do you approach that, though? I mean, there is an inherent tension in the positions of Elizabeth Warren and Bernie Sanders and how they deal with corporate America, and frankly, your experiences in corporate America.
Yeah, so I'm not trying to be them. I'm just saying that having worked in business, understanding that, frankly, most of us work in the private sector. We house, feed, entertain ourselves in the private sector. We ought to want that to be both prosperous and just in the same way we want the larger society to be prosperous and just. We ought to want that to be right. Now, we're not always going to make that right through regulation alone, right? Some of it is modeling the behavior that we're talking about.
Do you feel a responsibility or an opportunity to explain capitalism?
Well, more an opportunity. You know, I'm a capitalist, but capitalism has a lot to answer for. I'm not a market fundamentalist. I don't think markets get everything right just in time. I don't think markets substitute for the role of government, and I don't think government should substitute for the role of...
What does capitalism have to answer for?
Well, I think, frankly, we've had this very short-term focus. I noticed this a lot in some of my executive roles before running for governor, where, you know, let's get next quarter's results, sometimes without due regard to the long-term impact on the enterprise or on the community. And frankly, that same bad habit has crept into the way we govern, right? We govern for the next election cycle, next news cycle, and not the next generation.